很多澳大利亚人都注意到越来越多的在线赌博广告充斥在我们的电视节目中。
What's your secret?
You shall find it within
The Sports Bet App。
广告形式也多种多样，除了电视广告，球员的队服上以及赛事分析中都能见到赌博的踪影。这些广告的效果显而易见。根据联邦议会的一份最新报告，澳大利亚人每年在赌博上的花销冠绝全球。
Australians, unfortunately, are world record holders when it comes to gambling. We bet more than any other country in the world. We lose $25 billion per year on gambling in Australia. We also lose the most money to online gambling per capita of any country in the world.
报告显示，澳大利亚人参与在线赌博的比例在2010至11年只有12.6%，到了2019年已经增加到30.7%。2022年，几乎有一半的澳大利亚成年人称在过去一年里对体育赛事或者赛马下注赌博，其中大多数人使用智能手机或者电脑进行投注。最令人担忧的是受到赌博广告的影响。那些澳大利亚未来的主人翁们很早就接触到了赌博。
The children as young as 7 and 9 are starting to talk about sport essentially as a vehicle for betting. They talk about the odds. They can identify gambling companies by their colours and their logos. They don't talk about who their favourite player is or how skillful their favourite player is or whether their team's going to win. They talk about the odds.
经过6个月的听证会，并收集了160份意见书后，委员会提出了31项建议。其中最重要的是希望在3年内分阶段实现限制的措施，最终全面禁止在线赌博广告。这样的建议得到了反对党领袖和赌博治疗从业者的欢迎。
That we're up for a change in the way in which the laws operate at the moment. It is invasive for families and.We can have a conversation with the industry and the affected stakeholders, but in the end, the decision that we've made is to be on the side of families. And if the government can respond quickly to the report, tell us what they're going to do, then we'll be happy to consider it from there.
Since online gambling is an adult activity with inherent risks and links to gambling problems, it's important that this advertising is really pulled back so there's not this messaging that gambling is an appropriate activity without any safeguards needed.
而另一边，收益可能受到影响的赌博行业表达了强烈反对。
Complete overreach, when it comes to reform measures. This measure has the potential to rip hundreds of millions of dollars away from sports and broadcasters.
联邦政府表示，目前正在考虑这些建议，但还没有表态是否会完全采纳这些建议。